O Allah, grant us enough of your, or grant us a sufficient amount of fear of you that would create a barrier between us and your disobedience. That is amazing. So, O Allah, let us have enough fear of you that would create a barrier between us and sin against you. Whenever there is a sin to be committed, make us conscious of you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace and blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be upon you all. Alhamdulillahi wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillahi wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. We commence in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most forgiving, the most merciful. We seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as well, and we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon all conditions. We send blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his household, his companions. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless them all and to bless every one of us and to grant us goodness. My brothers and sisters, calling out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a way taught to us by Allah himself, by the Messenger, peace be upon him. And whenever we read a verse in the Quran where Allah is praising certain qualities of goodness, it is important for us to try and extract a way to seek the goodness from Allah. That was a sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When he read verses of heaven and Jannah and goodness, he always asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant that to him. And whenever he read verses of the fire, the punishment, those who were filled with misfortune, he always sought the protection of Allah from that type of a condition or from becoming from among those people. So today I want to commence with a verse where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Hujurat, verse number 7, describes goodness and he praises certain qualities. So a dua that is derived from that would be of benefit for all of us. Here is the dua. اللهم حبب إلينا الإيمان وزينه في قلوبنا وكره إلينا الكفر والفسوق والعصيان واجعلنا من الراشدين. This means, O Allah, make Iman loved to us. Make us love Iman, belief in you. Make it loved to us. وزينه في قلوبنا, and beautify it in our hearts. And make disliked to us disbelief, disobedience, or disbelief, sin and disobedience. Al-kufra wal-fusuqa wal-isyana. In that order, disbelief, sin, and transgression. So to go against the command of Allah, make it disliked to us. وَجَعَلْنَا مِنَ الرَّاشِدِينَ would actually mean make us from among those who are righteous, among those who are rightly guided, among those who have a good understanding, a sound understanding of the deen. So because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised these qualities and the people of these qualities in Surah Al-Hujurat, this is why we have derived words. And these words have been said from the very first generation, the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, and continuing all the way to this age. And that's why it's important for us to use the same words, to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant that to us so that we can also be from among those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has praised. Once again, Allahumma habib ilayna al-Iman. O Allah, make beloved to us Iman, belief in you. وَزَيِّنْهُ فِي قُلُوبِنَا, and beautify it in our hearts. وَكَرِّهْ إِلَيْنَا الْكُفْرَ وَالْفُسُوقَ وَالْعِصْيَانَ, and make disliked to us disbelief, sin and transgression. وَجْعَلْنَا مِنَ الرَّاشِدِينَ, and make us from among those who are righteous, rightly guided, you know, filled with wisdom, etc. So this is a beautiful dua that we should be calling out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with. I want to move on to another dua. This dua is made mention of in Sunan al-Tirmidhi in the hadith. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has been using these words to call out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Very comprehensive. You and I know that there is something known as qunut in the night. In Salatul Witr, just after Salatul Isha, the odd number of units that we read, right at the end, there is a dua. This dua is known as qunut, dua al-qunut. You know, that dua which is read in qunut. With utmost humbleness, concentration, we are calling out to Allah just before we've ended our day. What a beautiful, blessed way of ending the day. This Salatul Witr is something that we should never be missed. In fact, the hadith of Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, he says, Awsani Khalili. He says, my best friend has given me some words of advice. One of these pieces of advice was, An utira qabla an anama, to make sure that I fulfill the Witr Salah before I sleep. So that was the advice of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I'm sure every one of us can take heed, and we should make a greater effort to give this salah its special position and its importance. So we have a dua that is made within that witr at times, and this dua can be made at any time, any place. Allahumma qasim lana min khashyatika ma tahulu bihi baynana wa bayna ma'asik. It's a long dua. It starts off with, O Allah, grant us enough of your, or grant us a sufficient amount of fear of you that would create a barrier between us and your disobedience. That is amazing. So, O Allah, let us have enough fear of you that would create a barrier between us and sin against you. Whenever there is a sin to be committed, make us conscious of you. So khashya would also mean fear. It could mean the consciousness of Allah as well. So, O Allah, let us be conscious of you to the degree that it would keep us away from sinning. So this is a powerful dua where we are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whenever there is something wrong to be done, O Allah, we would like you to keep us away from it. Let us have enough consciousness of you, or fear of you, that it would actually keep us away from the sin. Allahumma qasim lana min khashyatika ma tahulu bihi baynana wa bayna ma'asik. The second part of that dua is, wa min ta'atika ma tuballighuna bihi jannataka. Wa min ta'atika ma tuballighuna bihi jannataka. And grant us sufficient obedience of you that would make us reach paradise, which is our goal. Obviously, the goal is paradise. So, O Allah, let us have enough obedience. Let us be obedient to the degree that that obedience leads us to Jannah and to paradise. The third part of that hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam used to call out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَمِنَ الْيَقِينِ مَا تُهَوِّنُ بِهِ عَلَيْنَا مَصَائِبَ الدُّنْيَا. This is amazing. Grant us enough conviction in you, such conviction that would make easy for us the difficulties, the trials, the tribulations of this world, this dunya. So we are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, O Allah, give us yaqeen, give us conviction to the degree that all the problems that we face on earth become easy. They become simple. We know that you are there for us. We know that what you're doing is the best. We know that whatever you have done, you are in absolute control. You're doing it for us and for our benefit. So this is yaqeen. So far, we've asked for three things. Number one is we've asked for enough consciousness of Allah that could be a barrier between us and sin. We've asked for obedience that could actually let us reach our goal of Jannah. We've asked for conviction that would make all the difficulties easy. Then the fourth part of the dua, Allahumma matti'na bi asma'ina wa absarina wa quwwatina ma ahyaytana. And in another narration, ma abqaytana. O Allah, grant us the good use of the faculties of our hearing, our sight, and our energy. These three things, the physical strength, the hearing, and the sight. O Allah, give us good use of these things, because the day you take it away from us, we don't want to regret how we used it. So my brothers and sisters, while we're asking Allah to give us good use of the sight that He has bestowed upon us, the hearing that He has given us, as well as the energy that He has given us, we should be making an effort to use these faculties correctly. No point in only asking Allah and then we do whatever we want and then we say, well, I've asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He didn't give me. Well, you need to make an effort as well. Imagine how beautiful this dua is. The Prophet, peace be upon him, is asking for this, yet he used to use all of these faculties in the best possible way. Then he says in the dua, وَاجْعَلْهُ الْوَارِثَ مِنَّا, and let the good use of these faculties be something that lasts long. It lasts right to the end of our lives and it goes even beyond that. You know, al-warith is generally referring to the heir. So let these be inherited from us. What is this? The good use of these faculties, let it be inherited from us in two or three different ways. Number one, let us be able to make good use of these faculties right up to the end of our lives. Number two, let the reward of the good deeds that we have done through our lives extend even beyond our lives. There is something called sadaqatun jariya, which means a charity that would last long, you know, that is continuous even after you've passed away. If you have delivered knowledge, taught knowledge, if you have been charitable to the degree that people are benefiting from your charities, even after your death, you will receive a full reward of all of that. And that is very, very important. It's definitely very beneficial. Thirdly, O Allah, let this the good use of these faculties extend even to our offspring and those whom we leave behind. Let people benefit from it, learn from it, and adopt it and practice upon what we have actually left behind, so that we will be rewarded for having left a good example. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Man sanna sunnatan hasanatan falahu ajruha wa ajru man amila biha ila yawm al-qiyamati la yanqusu dhalika min ujurihim shay'an." The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, whoever sets a good example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant them the full reward of having set the example, as well as the full reward of anyone who practiced upon that example right up to the end, the day of judgment, without a decrease in rewards for any one of them. So that is the multiplication that is being spoken about even here. If you used your faculties of hearing, sight, and your energy in a way that people learned from you to make good use of it, you will get a good reward for what you did, as well as for what you left behind right up to the day of Qiyamah. And this is included in the terms وَاجْعَلْهُ الْوَارِثَ مِنَّا, that, O Allah, let it be that thing that is inherited from us as well. وَاجْعَلْ ثَأْرَنَا عَلَى مَنْ ظَلَمَنَا, O Allah, let our revenge be precisely upon those who have oppressed us. Let the proper revenge or retaliation be upon those who have wronged us. When someone has wronged us, let us not, you know, seek revenge from the wrong people. Sometimes you don't identify the criminal in the proper way. Sometimes you might not, you know, you might be accusing an innocent person of having wronged you. This happens a lot. My brothers and sisters, I have come across cases where people say, this person did this to me and that person did that to me, when they did not do that to you. Someone lied to you. Sometimes people go to fortune tellers, they go to people who claim to be religious as well. And unfortunately, these people shamelessly take the names of others and say, that sister or that brother or that mother-in-law or that daughter-in-law or sister-in-law or that uncle and aunt or that neighbor did magic on you and they've wronged you. And so we hate them right up to the end, whereas they were totally innocent of it. Shaitan was guilty of lying to us through the lips of whoever we believed. We need to be careful of this, because we become guilty. And we will actually bear the burden of that false accusation or that dirty suspicion. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us goodness. I pause for a moment. I want to speak about how important it is to solve a matter, if you have a physical problem, a health matter, a mental, psychological issue, an issue within your home. You need to know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant you the cure. If you have the cure, you don't need to worry too much about who did what, because that is a distraction that will now make you lose relationships as well as the hereafter. If you want to stay away from someone for some reason, alhamdulillah, because there is physical evidence to prove that they did something perhaps, or they did not like you, or they have said words, etc., you may want to stay away in a good way. But if you have superstitious ideas and you are doubting people, that is extremely dangerous. What is more important is to cure yourself than to know who did something, especially when the evidence is very clandestine. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala safeguard all of us. So part of this dua, وَاجْعَلْ ثَأْرَنَا عَلَىٰ مَنْ ظَلَمَنَا. O Allah, let the revenge and retaliation from us be upon those who have wronged us. So Allah takes care of this a lot of the times, where people have wronged you, and Allah makes them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes them pay for that wrong. You did not have to really do much. You just made a dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the dua continues, وَانْصُرْنَا عَلَىٰ مَنْ عَادَانَا. O Allah, grant us victory over those who have fought us, those who have enmity against us. Grant us victory over those who have enmity against us. Don't let them succeed in any way. Look at how comprehensive this dua is. I actually love this dua and I use it very, very often. I try to repeat it in Qunut, and I try to add it into the dua of Qunut, because Qunut has a minimum, and then you may add in it the sunnah du'as of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and this is one of them. So, وَانْصُرْنَا عَلَىٰ مَنْ عَادَانَا وَلَا تَجْعَلْ مُصِيبَتَنَا فِي دِينِنَا. O Allah, never let a difficulty come into our practicing of our religion. Never let difficulty, hindrance come into the practicing of our religion or into our religion. So the deen, O Allah, don't make a musibah, a hardship, a difficulty, a hindrance in our deen. In our deen means our religion, number one, and two is the practice of that religion for us. So for example, when we need to dress appropriately, make it easy for us. Or when we need to fulfill salah, make it easy for us. Don't let a hindrance be created between us and the fulfillment of our faith. This is a powerful dua. Many of us don't make these duas until we're stuck. You see, the problem is we forget Allah. We only think of Him when we have problems. That is a fact. So people who have no problem wearing a scarf, they have no problem, for example, dressing the way they have to according to religion, they have no problem going for Salatul Fajr, filling the masajid, they have no problem, reading the Quran, etc. They will not thank Allah for that opportunity and they will not seize it. I know of many places where there is no hindrance, but people don't obey Allah. And the day the prohibitions come, the bans come, the problems come, then they are quick to say, what happened? We can't follow our deen anymore. Did you ever thank Allah the day that you could? No, you didn't. Or maybe you might have, but did you ever call out to Allah to say, oh Allah, don't ever let that happen to us. Oh Allah, don't ever let that happen to us. Many of us have not cried to Allah with that. May Allah forgive our shortcomings. وَلَا تَجْعَلْ مُصِيبَتَنَا فِي دِينِنَا. What a powerful supplication. وَلَا تَجْعَلِ الدُّنْيَا أَكْبَرَ هَمِّنَا. Oh Allah, don't let this worldly life, the material life, become the main object of our living. Subhanallah, don't make it our main concern. Akbara hammina, the main worry that you have, the main concern you have is this worldly life. Yes, it is a concern, but it's not the main concern. Wala taj'ali dunya akbara hammina. Oh Allah, don't let the material world be our main worry and concern. What is the main worry and concern? Your pleasure, paradise, the goodness, the fulfillment of the obedience of Allah, the abstinence from the prohibitions of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that should make you more concerned. You should be more worried and concerned about that rather than about the worldly material life. And there is a concern, but that concern should not extend to the point of becoming the main concern of your living. وَلَا مَبْلَغَ عِلْمِنَا. And oh Allah, do not let the worldly material life be the extent of our knowledge. You know, it's amazing how the Prophet ﷺ said this. Because what this means is, oh Allah, don't let the material world be our main concern of living. And the height of our knowledge, you know, the main concern of whatever we learn is to do with whether or not we're going to earn. I want to express something that many of us and our offspring, our family members, the Muslimin, are guilty of. It's a reality check. My brothers and sisters, we go to school, we go to universities, we study, we get jobs, we want a salary, etc. All of what we've learned is connected to earning. That's it. All of what we've learned is connected to getting a job, being able to earn, or getting a business, buying a business, getting a salary, whatever it is, being able to have something material. All of it. But how much of it is the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, concern about Jannah, concern about, whether I can read the Quran or not, whether I can understand the Quran? Many of us can be 60, 70 years old. We might have earned millions in our lives. We still do not know the meanings of the verses of the Quran. Is that not a reality? Subhanallah. So this is why Allah says, Oh Allah. Allah says to us through the blessed lips of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to make this dua, to call out to Allah, to say, Oh Allah, don't let the material life be our main concern or the height of our knowledge. Everything we learn is about the material life. Everything we want to know is about the material life. Today people know things because it's about the material life. How much of us know things that will help us in the hereafter? May Allah make it such that we take heed. Ameen. So this is a very important dua. The last part of it is, وَلَا تُسَلِّطْ عَلَيْنَا مَنْ لَا يَرْحَمُنَا. And in one narration, وَلَا تُسَلِّطْ عَلَيْنَا بِذُنُوبِنَا مَنْ لَا يَرْحَمُنَا. O Allah, do not impose upon us a leader who will not have mercy upon us. Subhanallah. Do not place in authority over us someone who won't have mercy on us. That is a powerful dua. You're asking here for leadership. You know, this is political leadership, or someone who has authority over you somewhere, anywhere. You are saying, Oh Allah, don't let anyone who's not going to have mercy on us have authority over us. What an amazing dua. So these are beautiful du'as. And in one narration, it says, Bidhunubina. Bidhunubina meaning, Oh Allah, because of the sins that we've committed, don't let anyone who's not going to have mercy on us have authority over us. It's got to do with the sins sometimes, and it's also got to do with the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Keep asking Allah, call out to Allah. What a beautiful dua. I'm going to repeat this dua, inshallah, for the benefit of one and all. We can actually say it in these beautiful, blessed days. It is something very, very powerful.
Allahumma qasim lana min khashyatika ma tahulu bihi baynana wa bayna ma'asiyatik. ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا اللهم متعنا بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقواتنا ما أحييتنا واجعله الوارث منا واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا وانصرنا على من عادانا ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا تسلط علينا من لا يرحمنا.
This hadith is in Sunan al-Tirmidhi. The meaning of it, O Allah, grant us conviction, or grant us the consciousness of you to the degree that it will create a barrier between us and disobeying you. And grant us obedience to the degree that it will lead us to your paradise. And grant us conviction to the degree that it will make easy for us the difficulties of this world. And O Allah, grant us the best use of the faculties of hearing, sight, and the strength and energy that you have given us for as long as we're alive. And O Allah, let it be something that is long-lasting, everlasting within our own lives and even beyond. And O Allah, let the revenge be upon those who have wronged us, and assist us against those who have fought us, or against those who have enmity against us. And don't, O Allah,
don't create for us difficulty in our deen or in the fulfillment of our deen. And O Allah, do not let this worldly life be the biggest concern that we have, nor the height of our knowledge, and do not place on us, one in authority who will not have mercy on us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all and grant us goodness. Inshallah, in the next episode, we will continue. أقول قولي هذا والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.